Welcome back. This is The Big Break. We have been looking at the first two contestants in our competition, the prize on offer. Let me remind you, $250,000 worth of advertising on the Arabian Radio Network and free office, free business setup at Dubai Airport Free Zone. Let's talk first of all about our first competitor this evening. He was in about half an hour ago, 20 minutes ago, Charles Al-Mamry of Pax Kent International with his idea for furniture. Edward Roderick is one of our judges this evening of Investors MENA. Edward, what did you make of Charles and his pitch?
I really just wasn't quite sure what it was that we were getting pitched on. I mean, we were getting wooden furniture with probably an RFID chip into it. I couldn't see what made it particularly unique. I couldn't really see how the RFID chip was going to be used to enhance the whole thing. Wasn't clear how the marketing strategy was going to play into it, or for that matter, where the strategy was to drive it forward, and that wasn't really articulated in terms of, you know, the markets that were going to be serviced or the geographies that were going to be serviced as well. And the returns, we were told it was an 18% return. I didn't know whether that was rate of sales growth, profit level, or return on invested capital. So just a bit unclear about directionally how it was all going to play out.
And compare that with the second company we had, which was Shimu's company, Devayani Dayal, the activewear.
Well, again, I think it's a bit apples and pears here. The second company is really brand new and therefore has very limited sales, certainly very little revenue and profitability, so that's unclear at this stage. Had to change direction after its very first foray into the marketplace. The people seem to me to have competence and capability and a good background in the sector that they're doing. And I thought that there was a better articulation of the uniqueness of the product. I'm not clear it's as unique as Devayani thinks it was, but I think that there was a good articulation of who was going to use the product and why and how it might be interesting to people in the marketplace.
Well, let's have a look at some of the SMSs we've had in. Broadly speaking, I've got to say our listeners seem to prefer Shimu's company to Pax Kent. First of all, some of the comments about Charles Al-Mamry's pitch for Pax Kent. Ed writes in, awful delivery, as wooden as his furniture. Someone else wrote in, what a nonsense. I'm afraid they're picking some of the nicer ones, if I'm honest. Some of those I can't read. Aligi says, worst sales pitch I've ever heard. Someone else writes in, this is reflective, I'm afraid. I'm not picking the bad ones here. Ian writes in, sorry guys, I listened to Charles. I have no idea what his furniture or his underwater robot do. This is not clear at all. So those are some of the comments we had in for Pax Kent International and Charles Al-Mamry. For Devayani Dayal at Shimu's company importing activewear, slightly more positive. Someone says, Devayani clear in her idea of business and is passionate. Being passionate is the essence of business. Saji writes in, Devayani's business plan is more sensible. Someone else writes in, though, Shimu's is too new, no track record, hazy about her figures, and no unique selling point. Here today, gone tomorrow. That's from Liz. So mixed reviews for Shimu's and Devayani, but pretty much overwhelmingly negative comments for Charles and his furniture at Pax Kent. Edward.
Yeah, I think that's a fair reflection, I think, of the relative strengths of the two people that were in here. It was reflected in the comments from the audience out there. I think it's difficult to make a judgment on the revenue and profitability of Devayani because really at this stage they don't have any. As I said, change in strategy, people seem competent. And I think the other side of the house, all of those things about sales and marketing and people and the business strategy and how it was going to be implemented just didn't really come across strongly enough from Charles to convince us.
An interesting comment coming in here about Shimu's, and it's something you mentioned. Shimu's is a trading business model with very low entry barrier. Many Me Too competitors will spring up, not clear about the competitive advantage. One of my concerns was it's just essentially importing stuff from outside. Now, if Devayani was coming up with some unique material that was, I don't know, created for desert conditions and the humidity we have here, and was working on a fabric that was ideally suited to these conditions, then I think, okay, you've got something truly unique that may work across the Gulf and perhaps in other desert conditions, and you, that would have got excited then. But importing stuff from America, it's great. I'm not knocking her. It's good business. You know, people import BMWs and Mercedes, and it's still a business. But just importing goods, yeah. I find a little shallow.
I agree with that. And I also wasn't terribly convinced by the idea that somebody did a sort of 90-minute workout and then went straight to have a coffee in the mall without having a shower and whatever, and that the flow-through ability of the sweat coming out of the clothes would necessarily be attractive to everybody around them, really. So.
Tim Elliott.
Do you know, one of the things that concerned me slightly was what Deviani said about activewear and the fact that there was no direct competitor. I just feel that there are many. There are lots and lots of competitors in the activewear. I mean, most clothing makers would have some form of activewear, whether it's some unusual space age material or not. I don't know. That was the one thing that stood out for me.
I'm thinking of crossover brands like Timberland, Columbia. Maybe Nike and Reebok perhaps are sportswear brands, but yeah, crossover. I'm thinking Timberland and Columbia, which are active here, and I think it's Sun and Sand, I think, it represents them, which is one of the biggest distributors of this type of clothing, a very strong competitor. You've got to have a really good product if you're going to go up against those boys. Okay, she's in the Address, which is good. The Address hotels are nice, and to be in Exhale Studios is good, but
yeah, well, the one thing that's clear is that the moment that any new product comes onto the market and the big boys see that it succeeds and it's going to sell, then they're in replacement and destruction mode, that they're going to find their own products to compete against it and try and take the competitors out.
But the point really is, isn't it, do we believe in Deviani enough? Is she the person that can lead this forward? Does she have the taste? Does she understand? Has she got the pulse, really, of the market here? Because one of the things she was saying was, look, I'm tailoring this with the not-too-plunging V-neck lines, culturally for this region.
I think you come back to the measurements that we always use in our shows when we have them, the three elements again. Do you like the concept? Do you believe in the people? And then the money flows thereafter. And I think what we're judging here is, did somebody articulate what their product or services do well? And were they able to convince us of their individual competency? And that's a decision we make.
Well, we are going to be giving our scores for both of these companies in just 1 minute's time. Stay with us for that. We're going to get Deviani and Charles back in the studio, and we'll find out who goes through to the next round and who is eliminated. Welcome back. This is The Big Break. Tonight, one company will go through to the next round and have the opportunity to compete for 250,000 dirhams worth of advertising on Arabian Radio Network and free office and business setup in Dubai Airport Free Zone. One company, though, will be going home empty-handed. We'll get the scores in just a couple of moments' time and find out who wins and who goes. First of all, though, both of our contestants, I'm going to ask you, give you 20 seconds to react to some of the comments and criticisms that we heard just now. First of all, Charles Al-Namri of Pax Kent International.
Yeah, well, thank you. Well, I thought the comments were very interesting, and things that we've got to take on board and listen to, that's a reality. I feel that we didn't come over clear enough, and we were not explicit enough in what we want to achieve.
Charles, thank you very much indeed. Deviani?
Hey guys, the main thing I wanted to tell you about that you mentioned was that our products aren't unique, and maybe I didn't explain it right. Some of our products use something called Blue Tech technology and Supplex. Those are very new fabrics. They're very unique. Nobody else has them here.
Deviani, thank you very much indeed. So with that, we get now to the scores. We've been scoring our contestants in five categories. They are a unique offering, sales and marketing, people, business plan, and revenue stroke profit. Tim has been collating the scores. Tell us, Tim, who wins, who goes through, and who goes home?
Charles, 37 points you finished the day with today. Deviani, 54.
Oh, okay.
Deviani, congratulations. Deviani Dayal and your company Shemus go through to the next round. Charles Al-Namri of Pax Kent International, many, many thanks indeed for joining us this evening. I've got to say, to get this far was quite an achievement. We had lots and lots of applications. Many people didn't even make it this far. So thank you very much indeed, both of you, for your time and for joining us this evening.
Thank you. Thank you very much.